Hello friends! Today we will learn how to create an overlay. This can be used for instance to display a menu for our hack inside the game or to draw those nice red rectangles used in ESP hacks. Generally speaking, there are two different ways of achieving this. One, create an external overlay, meaning a transparent window outside the game, but place it on top of the game window. Or two, internally by hooking some function involved in displaying stuff in the game. In this video, we will cover the second option.
But you know what I like a lot more than materialistic things? Knowledge.
That's a hacking group we've been reporting on that's claimed responsibility for recent attacks.
I should give a small warning. I will talk a lot more about what is happening and what we are doing in the following code than people usually do in their tutorials regarding this topic. You do not have to understand everything I'm talking about. My goal is to give you a broad idea. You do not have to understand every detail. Alright, let's get started. Since we go internal, we are gonna inject a DLL. Let's start with the code established in one of my previous videos. If you are already confused with this code, I recommend watching my video about self-unloading DLLs, linked above and in the description. The target of choice is Halo. Which Halo? The Halo. Halo uses DirectX 9. This means what we learned today will work for many other games as well, like CSGO for instance. For games using DirectX 11, it does work in a similar way, the basic concepts are the same. First, we need the DirectX software development kit, so let's download and install that. During installation, you may encounter the issue S1023. If that happens, you have to uninstall Microsoft Visual C++ 2010 x86 and x64 REST Rebootable. Then install the DirectX SDK and afterwards reinstall the current version of Visual C++ 2010 REST Rebootable package if you need it. After the installation is done, the environment variable dxsdk_dir should be added. You may have to restart your system for those variables to be recognized by the system. I don't know, for me this seems to be the case anyways. In our Visual Studio project, let's add the include and library directories. And since we are already there, let's make sure that the character set is a multi-byte character set. Setup is done. Now let's write our hook. We want to hook the function endScene. Why? Because all drawing methods are called between beginScene and endScene. So we insert our drawing as last methods before endScene gets executed. Therefore, we need the address of the function endScene. By address, I mean an address inside the game memory. The probably most elegant way to get this function is by creating a device object, then from that getting the virtual function table address, and from that the address of our target function. Are you confused yet? Let me explain. What is a virtual function table anyways? Also called virtual table or short VTable, it contains one entry for each virtual function that can be called by objects of the class. Each entry in this table is simply a function pointer that points to the function accessible by that class. EndScene is a function accessible by the device class. There's only one VTable, even if there are multiple instances of the class. So again, create object of type device, get its function table address in game memory, and from there the endScene function address. To create the device object, we first need to create an iDirect3D9 object. That's easy enough. Now we need to call its member function createDevice, which takes quite a lot of arguments. We don't have to care too much what is exactly being passed here, since we just use the created object to find the function table and nothing else. But since we are already here, why not pay a bit attention to what is actually happening? The first argument is the adapter. Here we pass default, which is the primary display adapter, meaning the graphics card. Second one is the device type. With this parameter choice, we tell it to use hardware to process graphics. Next one is a handle to a window which alerts Direct3D when the application switches from foreground mode to background mode. Then comes the behavior flags. Here we just pass a value specifying how vertices are being processed. Next we have a pointer to presentation parameters. So let's create such an object and assign some values. We do not have to care about those except the last one, which is specifying if it's windowed or not. This one actually matters, and the creation of the device can fail if the specification does not match our current game window. Meaning if we are playing in full screen windowed or windowed. So here what one can do is try to create the device with one of the options, and if that one fails, try the other option. In my case, the game window is always window mode, so I don't bother with that. Now let's pass a pointer to our presentation parameters, and the last parameter is a pointer to our device, or to be more specific, an interface to a device. So let's create such an object and pass a pointer to it. If the function succeeds, our object will be a valid device interface afterwards. To check if creation did in fact succeed, we can check the return value. If no error occurs, we can proceed to getting the vtable like so. Before we continue here, we need to tell our program how the endScene function looks like. First, the return value of the function is of type hResult. The calling convention for the function is stdCall. If you know a thing or two about calling conventions, this might be surprising to you. Maybe you are expecting this call. But the Direct3D classes are actually wrappers around C API, and the member functions are forwarded to stdCall functions, which take the class instance as first parameter. Okay, so stdCall it is. Next comes the function name, and then the function parameters, which in this case is only the this pointer. Let's create an instance of this function, since we will need it in a second. Back in our hook function, what we want to do now is detour the normal endScene function. The detour function we use is provided by msdetours. Yes, MS as in Microsoft. So let's place the according header and lib file in our project and link them. For proper interception, the target function, detour function and the target pointer must have exactly the same call signature, including number of arguments and calling convention. But what even is a detour? It's a change of the execution flow, meaning we jump to our own function, execute that one and then jump to the original function to execute it. So, first argument of this lovely detour function is the pointer to the original function. This one we just got from the vtable. The position of the pointer within the vtable is 42. The second parameter is our very own function, which will be executed every time the original function is called. So here we are, it's finally time to actually code what we want to display in game. As I just told you, the detour function must have exactly the same call signature, including number of arguments and calling convention. So here we go, that's settled. But what happens inside the function is up to us. I just created a small example here, a rectangle and some text inside that rectangle. If you guys want me to, I will show you how to create a basic menu in the future, but for now this will be good enough for testing purposes. Back in our hook function, we pass our detour function as second parameter. Then the only thing left to do is memory cleanup. In our main thread, we call the hook function. Now let's take a look at the result. Fire up the game, inject the DLL, and here we are. Amazing! We can now display our very own text inside the game, hooray! Again, if you guys want me to, I can show you in a future video how to create a decent looking menu for a hack. But the hardest part is already done at this point. Well then friends, I hope I could teach you a thing or two in this video. I sure learned quite a bit myself researching for it. Until next time friends, I hope you are all well, especially during those crazy times. Talk to you soon.